Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we'll be making Hyderabadi chicken dum biryani, which is very simple to make, less cooking time and the yummiest biryani. So anyone can make it, so without wasting any time, let's start. So first we'll be making fried onions, which is one of the main ingredients in biryani. So I have taken sliced onions and I'm frying it in high temperature to make it a crispy golden brown color. So as you can see, it will take hardly 4 to 5 minutes to make this fried onions. So it's now ready, so we're taking out in a paper towel. So here I'll be marinating chicken, which is the main step of this biryani. Here I've taken chicken leg pieces only. You can take any piece of your choice, or even you can take the whole chicken also. Here I am adding one whole lemon juice to it. Little bit of Kashmiri red chili powder, it will give a very nice color to the recipe. Little bit of turmeric powder, one pinch. Little bit of coriander powder. Ginger garlic paste, I am using here 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste. Salt to taste, and I'll be using curd here, 1 tablespoon of curd. Then here I am using biryani masala, that is Shan biryani masala. You can take any brand of your choice, but I would recommend this Shan biryani masala. It has a very nice fragrance. Even you will get the whole garam masalas in it, so it's the best, I think. But if you can't get it, then you can use any brand biryani masala of your choice. So almost 1 teaspoon of biryani masala, green chilies, freshly chopped mint and coriander leaves. It will give a very fresh texture to your recipe. Then fried onions, which we fried it. Mix it. You can add little bit of oil, which I forgot to add and I added it later. You can keep this marination for 2 to 3 hours, or even instantly you can cook it. So it's a very very easy biryani and it's yummy, so you can try it. Beginners can also try it. It's very easy. Just mix it and keep it in the freezer for half an hour. So in the meanwhile, where chicken is getting marinated, we'll be cooking rice here. So I have taken here 3 liters of water. To that I'm adding plenty of salt. The water should be salty, in that only the rice will be cooked very well and we'll get a perfect biryani rice. To that I'll be adding some garam masalas, whole garam masalas, that is bay leaves here. Star anise, I have taken it. Then I'll be adding here black peppers, green cardamom, cinnamon and black whole cardamom. So I have taken in this a tea infuser, so that I'll get the flavor of the garam masalas, but while eating the biryani I'll not get the bite of these garam masalas. So that's why I have taken an infuser, tea infuser. To this water I am adding ghee, 1 teaspoon of ghee, and I have soaked here basmati rice. You can take even biryani rice, that will be best. Soaked it for half an hour, so we'll be adding this. Then we'll cook this rice 80%. So here I have taken warm milk and added saffron to it, and in the other bowl I have taken little bit of biryani masala. To that I'm adding ghee. I will mix it and I'll be adding this, using this in the biryani layering. Trust me guys, this will add extra flavor to your biryani. Please don't skip this process. So as I have said that I forgot to add oil to my chicken marination, so here I'll be adding little bit of oil to my chicken marination. I'll again put in the fridge for 10 to 15 minutes. Here as you can see, my rice is 80% cooked. So how you will check, you just take one rice and just little bit press it. If it breaks, then it's 80% cooked. Drain whole the rice, take all the water off out and drain all the rice. So now we'll move forward to our layering process. So for that I have taken a heavy bottom pan. To that I have added little bit of ghee, or you can use oil also. And here I am layering sliced potatoes so that our biryani didn't get burned or didn't stick to the pan. It's a very nice process. If you want you can follow it or you can skip it also. So I always follow this process while making dum biryanis. So over that we'll be putting all our marinated chickens, all the marinated chickens at a time you can put it. Then on the top of that we can put freshly chopped coriander leaves and mint leaves, fried onions and the rice which we cooked. Layer it nicely. It's a very easy layering process. Over the top of rice you can put the saffron milk. It will give a very nice color to the rice. And here comes that the magic ingredient, that is biryani masala and the ghee, the mixture which you made. Freshly chopped coriander leaves and mint leaves, fried onions, and here I am using, this is meetha itar, this is used for biryanis only, but if you don't have this you can use kevra water also, even rose water also, essence, rose essence or biryani essence also you can use it. It will give a very nice flavor to your biryani and a very nice smell, fragrance to your biryani. So I'll be adding very little, only 1 to 2 drops. Then I have taken here aluminium foil and I covered that pan, and on the top of that I'm putting the lid. You can even make a dough and you can use that dough also to, basically we want to seal it very nicely so that the steam doesn't come out. And we'll be cooking this biryani in a high flame for 10 minutes, then on 20 minutes we'll be cooking in a very low flame. So here I have cooked this biryani 10 minutes in a very high flame. Then I am putting this pan on a tawa and I'll be cooking this biryani for 20 minutes in a very low flame. Then we'll give a standing time of 10 minutes before opening it. So after 10 minutes of standing time, our biryani is ready to serve. You can see it's looking so delicious. So our Hyderabadi chicken dum biryani is ready to serve. You can serve it with raita or any curry. Thank you for watching. Hope you have liked it.